Hi, I'm Melanie C, and this is The First Time. When the Spice Girls started as a band, we all introduced ourselves with our names. It was a little bit complicated because there were two Mels, so what are you going to do? We just, you know, the Mel B and the Mel C. We tried to keep it simple. But there was a magazine in the UK called Top of the Pops magazine. The editor of that magazine had decided to give us all nicknames, and they just stuck. And when we began to have success here in the US, nobody knew our real names. They just used our nicknames the whole time. So I think it was probably early 97 when I was first called Sporty Spice. And I love being Sporty Spice. Sporty Spice forever. Becoming famous is really, really weird. It's a really odd experience. I think lots of people, you grow up like really wanting it. You know, you want to sing, you want to dance, you want to be on stage, you want people to recognise you in the street, you want to sign autographs. And when we had our first UK TV...
New old girl band Spice and hit their new single, Wannabe. If you want my future,
forget my past. I don't know however many million people saw it, but it wasn't that many people. We'd been on TV once, and I went out shopping the following day after the show was aired, and I thought everybody knew who I was, but like not in a big head way, in a kind of I feel really self-conscious way, like everyone's looking at me. And it was nonsense because no one recognised me at all. It really takes a little bit of time, I think, for your face and your voice even to get into people's psyches. So I think the first time I was recognised on the street, I think I was relieved because at last someone recognises me. But then of course it snowballed and we had so much success as a band that sometimes it became quite stifling. But now things have kind of settled down a little bit. So we do get recognised a lot, but people are always so lovely. A female artist that really inspired me as a kid and is still going strong to this day is Madonna. So I met Madonna at the MTV Awards in 1997 here in New York. I remember watching her at Live Aid. She did a performance on stage and it was the first time I'd seen her performing live. Something just clicked inside me and I was like, that's it. That's exactly what I wanted to do. And, you know, she's inspired me ever since. So meeting her was a big deal. It happened so quickly for us girls. We were so lucky. We had our first single. It went in the charts in the UK at number 3. If you wanna be my lover, you have got to give. The following week, it went to number 1, and then it stayed there for 7 weeks. So we pretty much felt successful off the bat. But like kind of just success in life and everything, I think becoming a mum. I have this wonderful career that I'm very, very proud of. And now I have a wonderful little being that I'm very, very proud of too. So I feel very successful right now, 2019. I think I was about 8 years old. I moved schools and the towns where I lived and the accent was very different. And so I was bullied a little bit and I was bullied by the boys. And I remember having a fight with a boy. That's kind of girl power at an extreme, isn't it? I don't remember the very first time I cried to a song. I cried a lot on stage. Yeah, often people in the audience, when I see other people's reactions to your performance and the song you're singing, and obviously you see what it means to them, that can often make me cry, which is a pain because crying and singing don't really work well together. So yeah, that's my excuse for any bad vocals. I was totes emosh. The first time I released a solo album, I was so excited because I had this wonderful experience with the Spice Girls. It enabled me to work with incredible songwriters and producers. I did a single, Never Be the Same Again. I thought that we would just be friends. Things will never be the same again. My first UK number one, which is a big deal, a game changer. I was really excited for the world to hear what I had to offer as a solo artist, and I knew I just had such weight behind me with all of these great collaborators. So I was just more excited than anything. And it's 20 years old this year. Gosh, where did the time go? recently doing stadium shows, it's been really fun because I think the Spice Girls is a band where, because we have such identifiable looks, you know, you can really, you can quite cheaply dress as a Spice Girl. Victoria maybe is a little bit more expensive. When we toured the UK in 98, all the kids would come dressed as their favourite Spice Girl. And then when we came to the US, all the adults were dressed as Spice Girls. That was the big difference I saw, which I thought was really quirky. I don't remember it. But there are pictures to prove. I think I was like 2 or 3 and I did like some tap dance to a song called I Do Like to Be Beside the Seaside. It was a tap dance. I'm terrible at tap. I remember the first time I sang, I was 15 and it was a school performance. It was my first solo and wait for this. I decided to sing The Greatest Love of All. I mean, do you want to pick something easy? And my boyfriend at the time, like my school boyfriend, like my first love, was like in the front row. And I think I sang like the first half of the first verse, flat. So yeah, that was a very embarrassing moment. And I went on to sing again and again, so I'm a glutton for punishment.